a lot of lighthouses here in Denmark. Obviously, because Denmark has a lot of coastline. So there are huge lighthouses, small lighthouses, grey lighthouses, white lighthouses, and also a lighthouse that almost fell into the sea. Yep, that's not a joke. The Rubjerg Knude Fyr was built in the year 1900, and at that time it was like 200 meters away from the coast. In the year 2019, it was only 8 meters away from the coast. So the Danish authorities decided to rescue the lighthouse from falling into the water, and they actually moved it back from the coast to the land. That's a true story, but how the hell did all that happen? And why is a lighthouse actually like moving around? Let's find out. The Rubjerg Knude Fyr was built 120 years ago on a sand dune in North Jutland. And there we already have the problem. Not the lighthouse is moving around, it's the area around it. After the lighthouse was built, the wind blew more and more sand onto the dune and it got higher and higher. At that time there were two guardhouses right beside the lighthouse and they were literally swallowed by the sand. In the 1950s, construction companies started to carry away large amounts of sand from the top of the dune, but actually that didn't really help. The dune reached a height of 50 meters and in the year 1968 the lighthouse had to stop operating because it was surrounded by so much sand that the ships couldn't see it anymore from the sea. The authorities then started to put pine branches in the dune to stop the sand from drifting. But also that didn't help at all. The situation only got worse. So in the 1990s, the authorities finally gave up. They put the whole area under nature protection and decided to let the wandering dune wander wherever it likes. But that decision, of course, also affected the lighthouse. The guards' houses were totally spilled by the sand and destroyed. The museum beside the lighthouse had to close several times, and finally in the year 2002. The dune itself moved northeast and in the year 2012 it finally passed the lighthouse. During that, the coastal break doubled, which means, meanwhile, the lighthouse was standing so close to the edge of the cliff that it would have crashed into the sea in a few years. And that was the point when the authorities said, okay, we have lost our lighthouse, we cannot rescue it anymore, so let's just tear it down. But there was this one guy who said, okay, maybe we don't have to do it like that. Maybe we just move the lighthouse back. And yeah, that's what they did. So in summer 2019, construction workers arrived at the lighthouse and they put rails under it. And then they started to move the lighthouse 70 meters inland.
We reinforced the foundation with concrete and iron bars. And then we make a track with massive iron plates in three layers. And on top of those tracks, we laid a railway track, or kind of railway track. And on top of the railway track, we placed a number of jacks, 16 jacks. And those jacks were able to lift the lighthouse. And the movement of the lighthouse was created by two very, very huge hydraulic pistons that pushed the lighthouse to the new position.
Which was obviously not that easy because the whole building weighs 700 tons and the Danish government paid more than 600,000 euros for the rescue of the lighthouse. But that is actually worth it because there are 250,000 visitors who want to see the lighthouse every year. Rubjerg Knude Fyr is by far the most famous site in North Jutland.
Right now it's safe. We have moved it about 70 meters inland and the coastal erosion and the coastal profile moves inland with a speed of average 2.5 meters per year. So right now it will be safe for a number of years, approximately a generation. Of course we don't know about climate change, but 20 to 40 years. And then it's not safe anymore. Then the next generation have to decide whether the lighthouse would be teared down at that point of time or if they're going to move it again. And well, now we have showed that it can be done and how to do it.
So that was the story of a moving lighthouse. Special thanks to the YouTube user Sharani57 who allowed me to use his historical footage from the lighthouse in my video. If you like this video, please leave a thumbs up, and you can also check out the Patreon link in the description if you'd like to support me and my work. That's it for today. Have a safe journey and see you next time.